Hi everyone, myself Manu Kepi, working as a lecturer in Government Polytechnic Kushalnagar. So in this session of a DC machine and alternator, the sixth unit, the special motor, the servo motor concept will be teaching you the differentiation, the construction, the working and the principle of the servo motor will be going to study in this session. So, servo motor. This is a picture of a servo motor. This is how it looks like. And servo motor, the practically how it will be, is been showing here. So, first have an introduction about the servo motor. What the servo motor means like, what the main purpose we are going to have in the servo motor. A servo motor is a type of motor that can rotate with great precision. Normally, this type of motor consisting of circuit that provide feedback on the current position of the motor shaft, which have the rotor to get great precision. What do you mean this means? The rotor will be rotating the rotor. The position of the rotor is been fixed and the position you can control the where the exact position of the rotor is been, so that we can able to give for various applications where the position is a main important thing. Like the motor, if it rotates at the from 0 to 360 angle degree, no, will be rotating. We can able to control the position whether it's in 0 degree, 10 degree, 15 degree, 30 degree, 19 degree, 60 degree, or 180 degree. The exact position where the rotor, we can able to analyze and detect easily with the help of servo motor. This is the main criteria of a servo motor. Precision control, the controlling the position of the rotor, so which can be used for various kind of applications where the precision control is main thing, which will be telling you in the last part of this servo motor. So next, going to the servo motor in, we'll have the constructional details of the servo motor. So this is how the servo motor and cross-sectional view is looked like. We can see the rotor part, the stator windings, and the assemblies of all the things which are here in servo motor. So the servo motor, it's looking so beautifully, the rotor and the stator. So the construction part always consists of the main thing, the stator and the rotor, since the motor now will be having the stator as well as the rotor. So in this one, the stator and the rotor will have, see the stator part, look at the figure diagram. We can clearly able to see the windings now. The windings, it's a two-phase windings which we have been placed here in the stator. The coils, two coils, the one we can see with the white wired is coming out of the motor, and the second one is the red color wire coming out of the motor, the top coming outside of the motor. This is the two phases which we are implementing here in order to get the precision control, exact location where the rotor is. So let us have what the stators, how it going to work, and what are the parts. The stator has two distributed winding which are displaced from each other by 90 degree electrically. So we are using the two type of winding. The winding is been distributed mainly into two types. One for the rotation, another for the controlling. So we have to take two winding. The physically they appears, it appears as though they are one, but they're electrically different. They're electrically different and they have been displaced by 90 degree electrically. Electrically they have been displacement having phase displacement of 90 degree. So the next one, the one stator winding is called as a main winding. is excited by fixed AC voltage. The one winding, no? Huh? The one winding, for example, the red wire we are using, it's been a fixed wire, the main winding of this motor. It's been excited by fixed AC voltage. The AC voltage, no? Which is required for the rotation, is been provided by this main winding. Is the supply is been given by AC source, and the other winding called as control winding is fed by output voltage VA from an amplifier. So the main winding is to rotate the rotor, and second winding is to check the position, the precision where we want the exact location it has to stop and to rotate, how much degree it has to rotate. These are the things which helps it to make so precision control, the exact location it can hold at the same position and can rotate the next position with the help of this another winding, so called as control winding. This one. So the voltage VM and VA must be synchronism, which means that they must be driven from the same AC source. So the both the winding will place the stator winding in the stator part. It looks like they are one and the same, but the supply has been given from two different times. One is from the fixed AC, another one is from output. Output. What do you call that one as feedback? So what the thing is, they have to be synchronism. We cannot go out of synchronism. So for that purpose, what we're going to do, the same AC source will be given. But the thing is input, and this is the feedback, or other than the control winding. They must also have, they also made to have the phase difference of 90 degree by connecting suitable capacitor in series with the main winding. So the phase angle displacement which we're going to provide here, the 90 degree. Why we have to provide 90 degree? The phase angle displacement. It's been provided with the help of a suitable capacitor. If you do not provide a capacitor, then the phase angle displacement won't be there. If there is no phase angle displacement, then the rotation of the rotor, it will be difficult. For this purpose, what we're going to do is, for the main winding, we are connecting a capacitor in series with the main winding in order to provide the phase angle displacement, which helps the rotor to rotate easily and smoothly. So next is the rotor. See, this is the how the rotor looked like in a servo motor. The rotor is like a squirrel cage. We can see, no? It's a squirrel cage. The bars we have been, slots we have been providing over there, no? It looked like a squirrel cage rotor. This rotor will be having high resistance. The resistance we are providing here is a high resistance with low inertia. So this is a school cage rotor, no? The school cage rotor we are using here, and this school cage rotor is having high resistance. We are here using with low inertia. This is how the rotor looked like. This is the picture of a stator and the rotor. This is the what we discussed, no? The stator consists of a two winding, the main winding and the control winding, to in order to get the precision control of the rotor part. The rotor is made up of a squirrel cage having high resistance. This is the picture view of a servo motor. Next is the working. Look at the circuit diagram. Circuit diagram, we are providing a supply voltage, and an electronic amplifier we are using, then the control winding and the main winding. For the main winding, we are connecting a capacitor in series with the main winding. Why? In order to provide the phase angle displacement, no? For the rotor, the phase angle displacement is been given by the capacitor. So these motors are widely used in position controlling device. So position, the angles, no? The angles we are controlling, the main position. For this purpose, we are using this main winding and the control winding along with that and capacitor for position control. It is important that the torque to be reduced at high speed. So since it's been rotating at higher speed, servo motor have constant speed, they'll be rotating at high speed also. High speed. So when they are rotating at high speed, the torque has to be reduced, as the speed and torque cannot be the go in parallel. So one has to be high, another one has to be low. So when speed is high, the torque has to be reduced. For this purpose, what we are doing to prevent at torque during high speed getting overshoot, we call that as overshoot, to prevent the motor from overshooting its desired position. If the torque is more low, the position may get missed. It may go out of the position, that position. Hence, the torque has to be reduced at higher speed. To reduce this overshoot, no, what we make the rotor, we are going to make little modification in the rotor. What are the modification? No, we have to discuss over here. The squirrel cage rotor is made longer and thinner than the ordinary induction motor. The ordinary induction motor also looks like a squirrel cage induction motor only. What is the difference between that and this is, it will be made longer and thinner, the rotor. Then the rotor bars have high value of resistance. As I earlier said, no, the rotor will be having high resistance. We have to make resistance more so that the current will be limited to the rotor. To prevent the inductive reactance of the motor affecting the torque. So the torque, you won't get affected. The inductive reactance will be preventing the using that high resistance. As a result, the torque of the motor decreases as the speed increases. So what the one more thing I am going to say this here, we can see the control winding and main winding. Initially, the motor cannot rotate with one winding. So for this purpose, we are using the two winding, the main winding and the control winding. Initially, both are excited so that it will be rotating easily, and the capacitor helps it to rotate further more easily. With the help of the control winding, here we can able to easily control the position where we want to stop and again run. The speed will be moving very fast, high speed. So at the high speed, torque has to be reduced so that we can able to easily control the position. To reduce the torque at high speed, we'll be making a little modification in this servo motor. What are the modification is? The bars, no? The squirrel cage rotors, it will be made little more length, the longer one, and the bars will be thinner. So it will be thin and long so that it will be able to control the torque. And the resistance we are using here is high resistance. So all these features added together and make the motor able to control the torque at high speed. So next, the application. The application of the servo motor. These are the various applications of the servo motor. The first is the robotic application. So in the robotic one, we have the position control. For the robot, it has rotated the neck from straight to left or right. The position, it has to be 90 degree. Hence, the position is very important here. Hence, we go to use the servo motor. And the speed also is required. When it's lifting something, the robots, and it's walking, we all require the speed as well as the position. Hence, the servo motor has been used. Then the conveyor belt. In the conveyor belt also, we'll be moving the we are moving the items from one place to another place. In the trolley, the conveyor belt are moving. So it has to go from one particular application to next one to finish the work. So where the position is exactly same, it cannot be varied by inch also. So the exact position will be required. No, for this purpose, we are using this servo motor. And the camera autofocus. The autofocus, no, we will be using in the camera. It has to fix the position in order to adjust the persons or the picture, take the picture precisely without getting blurred. For all these things, no, we'll be using the servo motor. Exactly, it will be covering the things. In the robotic vehicles, in the vehicles also, we have to move straight, left, right, get back, reverse position. So in moving forward, it has to go 100 meter, 200 meter, in that way. It has to be the exact position. It cannot be varied. Then in solar tracking system, the way the sunlight is exactly the mode, intensity is more. It has to be rotated in that. For that purpose also, we are using the servo motor. In textile industries, we will be seeing various kind of activities. The embroidering, the stitchings. Here, we cannot go for, if it will move out of the position, it will be very difficult. It's a waste of the product. For this purpose, they will be using the servo motor, the stitching ones. And the text, the printing press. In printing press also, the print, the papers have to move continuously, without an even a single inch also, a single centimeter also, it must not vary the exact position. The one paper has to come, it has to get printed, then it has to move from there to next one, so that the next has to get printed. For this purpose, the position, what I'm saying, all this type is the position. For the position, the control precise for exactly this position. For this, we are using the servo motor. And the lastly, the automatic door opening. When the person enters, the door has to open. Not exactly when it's exactly near the front of the door. It has to get opened when it's 1 or 2 meters, 2 meters away to the door. So it can able to walk easily the doors. These are the various applications. So the servo motor now we are using here, the main purpose of an idea of the servo motor is to serve the position with speed. The speed is also very important here, and the speed has to be constant speed. It cannot be increase all of a sudden and decrease. The speed has to constant speed, it has to operate with speed. The torque has to be reduced. The position, for this purpose, what we are using here is, we are using two windings, one the main winding and the control winding. The main winding which helps to rotate the rotor, the control winding helps the rotor to fix one particular position so that we can be able to easily handle the things in the desired way which we are willing to work. These are the applications, the robotics, the conveyor belt, the camera, autofocus in the camera, the robotics vehicle, the solar tracking system, the printing press, the textiles, and the automatic doors. These are the things. So next, we'll have the multiple choice question. So the first one, an AC motor used in servo mechanism is dash. Yeah, the universal motor, the reluctance motor, servo motor, none of the above. Obviously, the servo, for the servo mechanism, the serving purpose, for serving mechanism, we'll be using servo motor only. The answer is third option, the servo motor. The next, the rotor used in servo motors are of dash type. What kind of rotors we'll be using? School cage, permanent magnet, closed, all of the above. Since here, the rotor, no, we are using, it's a school cage rotor. We are using a school cage rotor with high resistance, and the rotor will be longer and thinner in order to obtain the torque, to reduce the torque at high speed. So the rotor is a school cage rotor. The option is the first option. The next one, the next question here. As I say earlier, the school cage rotor has dash resistance and dash inertia. So resistance, high and high, the first option. Low and low, the second option. High and low, the third option. The final, low and high. So what will be the things? The solution is the high and low, the third option. Why? Just because the resistance has to be high. So in order to limit the current, and the torque will be reduced, and the inertia will be low. So it has to rotate at high speed, no? Hence, we are making the inertia to be the low inertia. Inertia is getting low. These are the features of the rotor. The stator. The stator has two distributed windings, which are displaced from each other by dash electrically. 30 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree, 60 degree. So the option is fourth option. It's a 90 degree. Why 90 degree? It has to be displacement, the distributed winding. So when the winding is been placed adjacently, if they are not displaced by 90 degree, then with the help of a single winding, the main winding, no, which I'm using, with the help of a single winding, we cannot able to rotate the rotor. It's highly difficult to rotate the rotor. Hence, what we are doing is we are using another winding. Hence, so the name is so called as distributed winding. With the help of these two windings, we can able to rotate the rotor at desired speed. So two winding, when they are displaced 90 degree, then only we can able to make the rotor to rotate. Addition to this, we are actually using one capacitor also in series with the main winding in order to get the initial torque for the rotor to rotate. It also providing a phase angle displacement of 90 degree, so that rotor can start smoothly and get sufficient torque to rotate the rotor initially. So for initial rotate also, no, we are using low inertia so that we can able to rotate the rotor very smoothly. For that purpose also, we are using the low inertia for the rotor. So next one, one stator winding called as main winding is excited by a dash voltage. So the windings, as earlier as told, we have discussed, it consists of mainly two windings, the main and the control winding. The main windings, the options are fixed AC, variable AC, fixed DC, variable DC. Here it's been varied from fixed AC. Why we are using the fixed AC means the voltage, we cannot vary the voltage. Sufficient voltage is always required for the rotor to rotate itself. Hence, what we are going to do is here we are using a fixed AC voltage is been used for the stator, for the main winding, which will make the rotor to rotate at our desired speed. So the school, next one, the school cage rotor is made longer and thinner than the ordinary induction motor. For what purpose? The shorter and thinner, longer and thinner. So I have missed the dash where I need to put the dash over here. So the squirrel cage rotor is made longer dash and dash than ordinary, it is more longer and thinner. Why it is made so longer and thinner means in order to get reduce the torque at high speed. High speed, we have to reduce the torque. For this purpose, we are making the squirrel cage rotor to be longer and thinner. These are the thing. So next, the rotor bars have high value of resistance that helps to prevent the dash of the motor. Inductive reactance, capacitive reactance, resistance, all of them. The option is inductive reactance. The rotor bars have high value of resistance. So resistance is made high in order to prevent from inductive reactance. Since we are using two windings here, it will be inducing the inductive part on the rotor. In order to reduce this and prevent this, we are having the high resistance rotor. The squirrel cage rotor we are selecting, you know, it's a high resistance. It gives us inductive reactance. It prevents from inductive reactance. Next one, the torque of the motor decreases as the speed dash. increases, decreases, constant, none of the above. The answer here is increases. The torque of the motor decreases as the speed increases, since we know the speed and the torque cannot go parallelly, side by side. One has to increase, another one must decrease. For this purpose, when the speed is more, the torque will be less. If the torque is less, the speed will be more. These are the factors which we have to consider. And we have made alteration for this also. High resistance, longer and thinner in the squirrel cage rotor. The torque is reduced at high speed to prevent the motor from dash its desired position. Undershooting, overshooting, level shooting, center shooting. Answer, the solution is the second option, overshooting. So the torque is reduced to prevent from getting overshoot. If we get overshoot now, then we cannot able to get the same position what we desire for. So for that, to achieve this, we are reducing the torque. The last, the servo motor as application in dash. Solar tracking system, camera, autofocus, robotic vehicles, all of the above. Yes, the solution is in all of this application we use servo motor only. Every part of this one has the position, where the position plays a very important role. Hence, the servo motor is being used in all these applications. So, this from till now we have studied and we have our knowledge about the servo motor, how it going to works, what are the windings on the stators, and in the stator part the two terminals, the windings, the stator wind, the main winding and the controlling winding, and how it going to phase angle displacement. Then here in the rotor, what are the alteration we are going to use in the rotor than compared to an ordinary induction motor, in order to achieve the positioning and to reduce the torque at high speed. These are the things which we discussed till now in this servo motor. So these are the references which we have used to make this session. BL Tereja, VK Mehta, and obviously the online sources. These are the online sources which I get the help from these sources. For video, we can go for this. And these are the team members who gave me the opportunity to give this session. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.